Okay, so in the quantum numbers, the third one is magnetic quantum number. Third one is magnetic quantum number proposed by M. Sorry, denoted by M and proposed by Landes. Proposed by Landes. So the magnetic quantum number. What is the symbol for magnetic quantum number? Small m. This magnetic quantum number values depends on L. L means what? Azimuthal quantum number. Azimuthal quantum number. So this magnetic quantum number's values mainly depends on L. And what are the range of M values? The M values are range in the form of plus L, zero and minus L. After finishing this concept, spin quantum number, I will tell you some bits regarding quantum numbers, what type of questions they are asking. Few bits, 2-3 bits I will discuss, then we will get more idea about that, how to solve quantum numbers related objective questions. So now the M values are in the range from plus L, including zero, plus L, zero up to minus L. The total number of what are all R integers? What are by? All R. Hey, first listen. Don't disturb. The M values in the range L, not R, this is L. Small L, L means what? Azimuthal quantum number. So the M values are depends on azimuthal quantum number, and these values are in the range from plus L to up to minus L, including zero. Like how many number of total M values are present? For particularly the M values depends on L value, then the total number of M values are 2L plus 1. The total number of L values are 2L plus 1. See, this total number of M values. The total number of M values. The total number of M values indicates the total number of orbitals. Total number of orbitals present in a subset. Present in a subcell. For example, S subcell is present. For S subcell, L value is 0, then 2 into 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. So M value is 1 only. It indicates one orbital is present. For P subcells like 2P, 3P, then L value is 1, then total number of M values are 2 into 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. So in P subcells contains how many orbitals are present? 3 orbitals are present. What are those 3? Px, Py and Pz. So the total number of M values indicates the total number of orbitals present in a subcell. Present in a subcell. That is very, very important. Let's see the next. Mainly it explains the orientation of orbital. Orientation of orbital in an atom. What is meaning for orientation? Orientation means direction. Orientation means direction. Now let's see the total number of M values. The total number of m values is equal to 2l plus 1 is equal to number of orbitals present in a subshell. So one orbital contains maximum how many electrons, ma'am? 2 electrons are present. Then if you have 2l plus 1 orbitals are present, they contain how many number of electrons? That is 2 into 2l plus 1. The total number of electrons present in subshell, present in a subshell, is equal to 2 into 12 plus 1, is nothing but 4l plus 2. 4l plus 2 electrons are present in every subshell. So the total number of orbitals in every subshell is equal to 2l plus 1 is equal to total number of m values. The m values are in the range of plus l including 0 up to minus l, including 0 up to minus l. Let's say I will give you one tabular form. Regarding the tabular form, we can understand that what is the importance of magnetic quantum number. Importance of magnetic quantum number. Let's see L values. L values already we know that. L values starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, like it will starts up to n minus 1. For every L values, we can identify their subcells, or we can identify that total L values. Total number of m values. Total number of m values. How many total number of m values are present? 2l plus 1. M values are present. Then particularly m values. For every orbital having particular one m value is present, then number of orbitals. Next you write subshell and number of orbitals. In a subshell, number of orbitals in a subshell is nothing but that is also 2l plus 1. Let's see this tabular form. We know that l equal to 0 means substitute that how many m values are present? Only one m value is present. So the m values ranges from plus l, 0 up to minus l. But here only one m value is required. What is that m value? That is 0. Then it is a subshell. So m equal to 0, m is equal to 0 means it belongs to s orbital. If l equal to 0, m value is also 0. Only one m value is present. That is equal to 0 means it belongs to s subshell. So s subshell contains how many number of orbitals are present? Only one orbital is present. Only one orbital is present. Let's see. L equal to 1, substitute that L equal to 1 value, you get total number of m values 3 we are getting. The total number of m values 3 means, see, plus L, 0, minus L. Plus L, 0, minus L range means the 3 m values, plus 1, comma, 0 and minus 1. Plus 1, comma, 0 and minus 1, it belongs to P subshell. Already L values and subshells we know that L equal to 0 means S subshell, L equal to 1 means P subshell, L equal to 2 means D subshell. So D subshell contains how many orbitals? That number of orbitals present in a D subshell depends on total number of m values. Total number of m values formula is equal to 2L plus 1. So that's why whatever the subcell, S subcell, you take 1S subcell, 2S, 3S, 4S, they have only one orbital is present, its M value is always 0. M value is always 0 because only one M value is present. That's why S subcell having only one orbital is present. Any P subcell you have to take, for C sub P subcells, L value is only 1, then they have 3 M values. The 3 M values means the P subcell contains 3 orbitals are present. Each orbital, 3 orbitals, what are the 3 orbitals? Px, Py and Pz orbital is present. The Px orbital M value may be 1 and Py orbital M value is minus 1. Pz orbital M value is 0. Like for every orbital having one specified M value is present. So the M values indicates that orbitals. So M equal to 1 indicates one specific orbital is present. It is belongs to one orbital particularly. M equal to 0 means it belongs to one orbital. So the for every M value is specified for orbital, one orbital. So L value is 1. Then it has total 3 M values are present. It belongs to P subcell. So that's why P subcell contains how many orbitals are present? Only 3 present. What are those 3? Px, Py and Pz. It is only S. Next, come to that. L equals to 2. L is equal to 2 means then total how many M values present, man? Substitute that L is equal to 2, then we are getting 2 into 2 plus 1 is equal to 5. So what are those 5 values range? Plus L, 0 up to minus L means plus 2 comma plus 1, 0 minus 1 comma minus 2. Count that, how many values this? 5. It indicates D subcell. So the D subcell contains how many orbitals are present? 5 orbitals are present. What are those 5 D orbitals? Dxy, dyz, dzx, comma, dx square y square and dz square. So these 5 values, for example, dxy, m value is plus 2 if you are thinking, then dyz, the m value is plus 1, then dzx, m value is minus 1, dx square y square, m value is minus 2, and dz square value, m value is 0. Like that, just I am saying 1 plus 2 is belongs to dxy, plus 1 belongs to dyz, 0 belongs to dz square, and minus 1 belongs to dxz, minus 2 belongs to dx square y square. Like every orbital having one M value is present. The total M values indicates the total number of orbitals present in a subcell. Total number of orbitals present in a subcell. So the M values depends on L. M values depends on L value, and the total number of M values is equal to 2L plus 1, and the M values specified M values range is from plus L to 0 up to minus L. So L is equal to 2. It is the range. What is the range? Plus or minus 2, 0 up to means plus 2, plus 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2. It is the range. Then we are getting 5 values. For example, L equal to 3. L equal to 3 means here substitute, then we will get 7. So 7 M values. How the 7 M values are present? Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. You count the total 7 is came or not? So it indicates which subcell? F subcell. If L equal to 3 means it is very clear F subcell. The F subcell M values are in the range from minus 3 to plus 3, including 0. Total how many M values are present? 7 M values are present. So F subcell contains how many orbitals are present, ma? F subcell contains how many orbitals are present? F, 7 orbitals are present. 7 orbitals are present. F subcell contains how many orbitals? 7 orbitals are present. Now, S subcell has only one orbital is present. It contains how many maximum number of electrons? the total maximum number of electrons in a subshell is equal to 2 into 2L plus 1. Number of electrons, 2 into 2L plus 1 means 2 electrons. Here 6, here 10, here 14 electrons are present for us. Like number of electrons also we can calculate. That's why the formula what I said, number of electrons, total number of electrons, 2 into 2L plus 1. 2 into 2L plus 1. So this is about magnetic quantum number. So the magnetic quantum number values mainly depends on azimuthal quantum number. And the magnetic quantum number values are in the range of plus L 0 up to minus L. Plus L 0 up to minus L. It is very clear. And the total number of M values is equal to 2L plus 1. This value indicates that how many number of orbitals present in a subshell. That's why it is very clear for a subshell contains one orbital only present. For every p subshell, any p subshell, r value is 1 only. It contains total 3 m values are present. That's why p subshell has 3 orbitals are present. For every d subshell, l is equal to 2. It contains total 5 m values are present. That's why d subshell having only 5 orbitals. F subshell, r value is always 3. Then it contains total number of m values 7. It indicates that every f subshell contains 7 orbitals are present. Okay, that's why mainly magnetic quantum number indicates that orientation of orbitals or direction of orbitals, how they are directing, either directing towards x axis or y axis or z axis. Px means the orbitals lobes present along on the x axis. Py, the orbitals lobes present on y axis. Pz, the orbitals lobes present on z axis. Dxy means the orbitals are present in between the x and y axis. Yz, the orbitals are present in between y and z. So it indicates that orientation of direction of orbitals present in an atom. So it explains by the magnetic quantum number. So the total magnetic quantum number values indicates that total number of orbitals present in a subshell. Present in a subshell. And total number of electrons present in a subshell is equal to 2 into 2L plus 1. 2 into 2L plus 1. It is very clear. Now tell me, anybody have doubt? Abhay, Nishchal, Abhi, Aditi, Afjab, now clear? Abhay, yes ma, m value is nothing but it indicates mainly number of orbitals present in a subshell. For every orbital having one specified m value is present. Okay, clear? So m value is 1 means it is belongs to one orbital. One orbital contains maximum how many number of electrons ma? 2 electrons are present. 2 electrons are present. One orbital like px orbital you take it takes maximum 2 electrons. Py orbital you take, it takes maximum 2 electrons. That type of question also they are asked previously. I will discuss that question also. Okay students, let's see the next quantum number is spin quantum number. The next one is spin quantum number, fourth one. Spin quantum number proposed by Uhlenbeck and Goudsmit. Uhlenbeck and Goudsmit. Okay. It is denoted by MS, means total spin values. MS means spin. So it is independent of remaining quantum numbers. It is independent of remaining quantum numbers. Yes, ma'am. For this case, we have to remember the name of the scientist for quantum numbers. That's why I am mentioning the names who's proposed. Okay, students. It is independent of remaining quantum numbers. Means the spin quantum number is independent. Means it does not depend on any either principal quantum number or azimuthal quantum number or magnetic quantum number. Remaining quantum numbers. Okay, let's see its values are, means its values are plus half and minus half, means plus 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. For every m value, m value has both spin values. Every m value means every orbital, each orbital. Every m value means each orbital having both spin values means either they have plus half and minus half also present. It indicates the one orbital has maximum 2 electrons present. 2 electrons present. If electron rotating clockwise direction, its spin value is plus 1 by 2. And if it is rotating anti-clockwise direction, its spin value is minus 1 by 2. So, for every electron present in an orbital, it has two types of directions are present. One is clockwise direction. In the clockwise direction, its spin value is plus 1 by 2. If it is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, then its spin value is minus 1 by 2. And for example, this P sub cell contains three orbitals are present. Not rotates half, ma. They are considering the spin values 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. Because for one orbital, it is px orbital and py orbital and pz orbital. Px, py and pz orbital. One orbital, they having maximum 2 electrons are present. One electron is present in clockwise direction that indicates the direction is above, and another electron is anti-clockwise direction. That's why if one electron is rotating clockwise, just half degree it is rotated, then another electron what will do? It rotate anti-clockwise direction. Then the total spin, let's see, standing here, just I rotated right, means left side I rotated, again, see, just I am standing here, it is clockwise direction, I rotated like this direction, 50%, immediately anti-clockwise direction, it rotated, and again I am coming the first position, means plus half and minus half, means automatically the total resultant spin, what happens, ma? One is two electrons are present, one electron is in clockwise direction, another electron in anti-clockwise direction, then its spin value is plus half plus minus 1/2, plus 1/2 plus minus 1/2 is equal to 0, the resultant spin equal to 0, means it does not rotating total in clockwise and total in anti-clockwise, but only one single electron is present, one single electron is present around the nucleus, it may rotate either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise. Only one single electron is present, we can't identify whether it is rotating clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. But two electrons are present, they must, one should be clockwise, another should be anti-clockwise. Then the total spin is equal to 0, the resultant spin is equal to 0. Because one value is plus 1/2, another value is minus 1/2. They are considering these numericals directly, don't think about one, why they are considering plus 1/2 and minus 1/2. These numericals, spin of electrons, they are considering 1/2 only. So they proposed spin quantum number values, two values only present for every electron, that is 1/2, another one is minus 1/2. When plus 1/2 we are considering, the electron is rotating in clockwise direction. When minus 1/2 we are considering, when the electron is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. In one orbital, they having maximum two electrons are present. The two electrons, how they are arranged? The two electrons, they cannot be present in that same direction. It is wrong arrangement. This is the correct direction. One is in clockwise, another should be anti-clockwise. That's why the total spin will be zero and the two electrons are stabilized in that particular orbital. Because electrons, repulsions will take place. The repulsions means due to that increasing the repulsions, what happens, ma? Atom will become unstable, but the atom is stable because the electrons are present in anti-direction. One is in clockwise direction, another one is in anti-clockwise direction. Okay? Okay. That's why the atom is stable, but whenever they are having one single electron is present in one orbital, in that case, the electrons are involving in chemical bonding and stabilizes. That's why molecules are stable when compared to atoms. Due to that reason only, the atoms try to get octet electronic configuration, they involving in chemical bonding. They involving in a chemical bonding. This is about a spin quantum number. Let's see. Now we have to solve 2-3 questions related to quantum numbers. Just listen, one important question. If L equal to 3 and N is equals to 4, belongs to which subset? Which subset and how many electrons present? How many number of maximum electrons? How many? How many maximum number of electrons present? How many maximum number of electrons present? So let's solve this question. Tell me the answer. Only two members did. Yes, Afjal, very good. F subcell. What is that F subcell? Exactly, tell me. Based on that n, n equal to 4 and l equal to 3. Yes, 4f. N equal to 4 means l equal to 3, that is f. In f means particularly present in which cell? The cell number indicates n, means 4f. 4f subcell. This 4f subcell contains how many maximum number of electrons are present? And how many orbitals are present, tell me? How many orbitals? Number of orbitals in 4f is equal to total number of m values is equal to 12 plus 1. Then how many orbitals are present in 4f? 7. 2 into 3 plus 1 is equal to 7. How many electrons are present in 4f? Second answer not said. 32. How you will get 32? 32 is total electrons present in f subcell. Total electrons present, not f subcell. Total electrons present in n cell. N equal to 4 cell. Our fourth cell, but here only in 4f, number of electrons in 4f is equal to 2 into 2l plus 1, is nothing but 4l plus 2, 4 into 3 plus 2 is equal to 14 electrons. Or otherwise, if you know the total number of orbitals present in 4f, 7, each orbital takes 2 electrons, 7 into 2, 14. Otherwise, we can solve like this also. Means 2 into 12 plus 1 is nothing but 4l plus 2. Then that l place you have to substitute 3, then we will get total 14 electrons are present. Okay, now clear? Nishal, Sandarya, Seema, Abhay. Afjal, understood ma now? Huh? 14 electrons. Now let's see the second question. This is very, very important. These model questions are very, very important. I will tell you one important question, that is, consider the following set of quantum numbers which are not possible. Identify. Okay, let's see the first set. Here I am giving N, L, M and spin. N value is 3, L value 0, M is 0, the spin may be plus 1 by 2. Spin always, whatever it may be, plus 1 by 2 or minus 1 by 2, it is always correct. But we have to check whether the spin value, instead of plus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, any other value they given, means it is wrong. That is the first set. Second set, 2, 2, 1, plus 1 by 2. The third set, 4, 3, minus 2, minus 1 by 2. Fourth set, 1, 0, minus 1 by 2. Fifth set, 3, 2, 3, plus 1 by 2. Tell me that. Already I said, n and l value, what is the relation?